Today, in this lecture, we will learn about shear force and bending moment. Before we start, we need to know some terms. Some of them we already know. We will start with a beam. We all know beam is a structural member which used to take the transverse loads. That means the direction of the forces are perpendicular to the axis of the beam. Now, there are several types of beam we can see in our daily life, in our engineering life. So, the first kind is cantilever beam. Cantilever beams has one end fixed and other end is free. This type of beams are called cantilever. Number two, simply supported. The two sides are resting on the supports. This is called simply supported beam. Okay. Number three, there is overhang beam. That means one end or maybe both end, that depends, are overhang from the supports. So there is an overhang portion. This portion is overhanged. So this is why it is called overhang or overhanging beam. Okay. Number four, which is fixed beam, which has both ends fixed. This is called fixed beam. And number five, this is called continuous beam. A beam which is having more than two support is called continuous beam. So when some portion is out from the supports and there are more than two number of supports, then it is a continuous beam, as well as there is overhang portion, so that's why it is called overhang continuous beam. If it is only this much up to the supports, then it will be called continuous beam. Okay, now we will learn different type of loading. When a load is acting on a beam at a particular point, then it will be called point load. When on the beam some force is uniformly distributed over a particular area, here on this much area this load is uniformly distributed and it is shown as W Newton per meter. There are different units may be applicable. So a particular weight is uniformly distributed throughout this area. So now this type of load is called uniformly distributed load. And if loading starts from zero or a particular value and goes uniformly up to a certain limit,